welcome to another episode of Elizabeth Plays Subnautica with Science! My name's Elizabeth, and today we are playing another episode of Subnautica. I actually already played a little bit, but then the game kind of glitched out on me like crazy. It's better this time. The gun is there. That's what we did last time. We watched this thing shoot some of our friends out of the sky. We don't want that to happen again. So I guess our long-term goal is to try to shut down the power of the facility using the coordinates of another alien facility somewhere else on the planet. But before we can do that, we have to have the ability to go really deep underwater, and we don't have that yet. So our goal this week is to make that mobile vehicle bay and see what we can build. But first, we're heading back to this pod. And while I do that, I'm going to give you some disclaimers for this episode. Creepvine seed clusters. Disclaimers. First, this show is entirely my own. None of the views, opinions, etc., whatever, expressed here are necessarily those of any of my employers whatsoever. This show is all me. I take full responsibility for it. Second disclaimer, all of the facts on this show, what is that? Am I going back towards the island? No, that's just the game being glitchy. I try my best to, be accurate on the show. I, take notes. Alright, I'll then take some fluid. No, don't drop it! Where did it go? Please don't get eaten. Where did it go? Oh, that's a stalker. I don't want that. Don't want that. Don't want the bone shark. Let's pick up one of these so that when we get back, we'll hopefully have... Cool. Hey! I don't want that. I'm getting out of here. What are you doing to me? Trying to avoid you, man. I promise I'll get through these disclaimers eventually. There is a chance, because I'm doing this all off the cuff, that I may have some inaccuracies in my show. If you see me say something wrong, please tell me. Ooh. That's a life pod we didn't know about. Do we have a way to get in it? That's a stalker right on top of us. Ow! I'm trying to get out of here. Jeez. We'll come back to that. But yeah, if you see me saying something wrong, let me know, and I will do my best to correct it, either immediately or later. Now, final warning. This is what I'm going to be calling a very special Valentine's Day episode, which means we're going to be covering... animal reproduction in all of its forms. This can be a fun thing because animal reproduction is weird and creepy. There's an awful lot of variation to it. On the other hand, this does mean we're going to be talking about sex, including some of the squishy, gross sides of it. So if that bothers you, maybe not the stream for you today. Okay. Now we are severely dehydrated. Let's fix that. We're all out of med kits. Let's go ahead and eat one of our nutrient blocks, because why not? I'm sure we'll get more. Oh, that turns on our headlights. Don't know how I didn't notice that before. Okay. So what have we got here? We've got a ton of stuff that we brought back from the island. And I think, assuming the game cooperates, it's time to go ahead and put that in one of our lockers. so that we don't lose it. That's titanium. Let's go ahead and put titanium into the titanium box. And what the heck, we'll put our silver in there too. And we'll put... what's in here? Oh! Other stuff. I didn't mean to edit the locker label, I meant to put things in it, but that's okay. More titanium. And one empty slot. Let's go ahead and put our lead in there, because we've already got a lead. And, no, don't do this to me again! This is what happened last time! I guess it just doesn't like that particular spot? Pick up a Gary fish. Kelp seeds. Yeah, no, there's no more room in there. If I had more space, I'd take it and distill it to make lubricant, because, that's good. Oh, boy. Alrighty. Oh, we can just drop our rotten boomerangs. That'll clear up some space. Let's go ahead and grab a few more, fish. Bladderfish. They'll be easier to see after the sun goes down. Although I don't know if it's going down so much as it is just eclipsing right now. Don't want to go down there, because those guys will get us. Is that a whole fish? I like whole fish. They have personality. It's very rare that there's a fish with a hole straight through it. There are none that I know of on planet Earth. This appears to be unique to this planet here. Come on, where's all my bladderfish? So much for cruising coolly along the top of this thing. Please don't eat me, Stalker. I'm just staring at you from afar. Admiringly. Oh, and actually, that brings me to our first actual science news article from this week. I'm not going to be doing a lot of that because it's Valentine's Day. And what better excuse do I have to talk about just random animal reproduction stuff? But one cool science news item from today, actually, was the discovery of a... Well, it's not exactly a dinosaur. It's in the same group as dinosaurs, but then it's also in the same group as birds and crocodiles. It was an ancient sea lizard, lived around the same time as the dinosaurs, called, what's its name? Dinocephalosaurus. Think plesiosaur. It looks a lot like a plesiosaur. Ooh, we've got a message. And the cool thing about this thing is that unlike most other things in that group, we can cure these things. Yes, please. Cure the whole fish. So we have a salt deposit. Unlike many other archaeosaurs, including, like I said, birds and dinosaurs, this one was found with a fossil inside it. And this fossil indicated that it gave birth to live young. There was a curled up Dinocephalosaurus inside it, and it was a baby sized. Now, this could mean that it had eaten a baby Dinocephalosaurus, and that would not be unheard of. Things eating their own offspring is quite common in the animal kingdom. However, they noticed that Dinocephalosaurus swallowed fish head first, usually, and this one was curled up in a fetal position with the head pointing back towards the mother's head. So it was in the right place for it to be in whatever reproductive tract it had. So those are the indications that they had. Let's go ahead and check our messages. Alien things. Super helpful. The sun is setting. Actually, you know what? Before we do any more, let's go ahead and, shut up, whales. Let's go ahead and check out what we need to make some of the blueprint stuff we made last. We picked up. So we picked up, all the things we need to make this mobile vehicle bay, which I think is super cool. So we need a titanium ingot, which I know I've got lying around somewhere. We need lubricant. Picked up all those kelp seeds. That should not be hard either. And a power cell. Now, what do we need to make a power cell? We can make more equipment. Ooh, floating air pump. Cool. And a purple artifact. I mean, that's cool. I don't know when we're going to use it again. Probably when we go eventually find that other alien thing. Now, we still need a radiation... We still need a fiber mesh for that radiation suit, which... Maybe it's more survivors! Or, please don't be another rescue ship. You're just going to get shot down. Life pod 4, coordinates attached. So we've stumbled across life pod 3 by accident. Well, now we got more access to blueprints, I guess. What did we want? We wanted to find... Okay, we now have Habitat Builder. Cool. We might need that. Air Bladder. Survival Knife. Flashlight. We can make a flashlight. We've got a... That would be useful. Repair Tool and Scanner. And now we have everything we need for a laser cutter. If we just go grab some of the titanium out there, this makes me happy. I've been wanting a laser cutter for days in-game. I can cook a peeper. We're not hungry, though. I also wanted to check, excuse me, power cell, two batteries, and silicone rubber. Well, I believe silicone rubber is also something... There, we need that fiber mesh. We can get benzene, I think, on the island. I still don't know where to get fiber mesh, though. Oh, no, wait. We can't get that because we need blood oil. Don't know where to get fiber mesh. Dang it. So, we can make plasteel. Cool. Bleach, glass... Silicon rubber, creep vine seed cluster times 2. And so basically we need a whole bunch of creep vine seed clusters. Fortunately, ooh, I meant to go down instead of up. Fortunately, we have those. Where's our creep vine locker? I don't want to edit that. I just want to open it. Thanks. Let's go ahead and stash our magnetite in here, too. And what do we got in here? We're gonna need some titanium. Let's take that out. And what are we not gonna... We're not gonna need ion crystals. Let's put those in there. And we need to keep our diamonds safe, along with our magnesium and our gold, for sure. Well... I'm not going to need the creature egg, probably. Let's put the gold in there. And that's our kelp seeds locker. Boy, are we going to need you. Thanks. And meanwhile, I can stash my lithium and my uraninite. Sure. That can all go in there. All right, I think we're good. Let's make some stuff. Oh, we're a little low on water. We don't have any more bladderfish. Oh, well. We need to make a power cell, for which we need silicone rubber, which we have the ingredients for. Now we can make a power cell. Let's do it. I'm gonna need to make more batteries after this, though. And we can make a waterproof locker that's super helpful. What else do we need for this thing? Lubricant! And it's titanium ingot, which I, again, I know we have around here somewhere. Basic materials. 3 creepvine seed clusters, and we only have the 1. Let's stash that. We don't need the dead battery anymore. Let's see here. My titanium ingot. There we go. Actually, yeah, I think we can just leave that in there. So we still need creepvine seed clusters. Let's go ahead and make one more titanium storage locker because, man, they come in handy and we are so short on storage space. Like I said earlier, titanium is so plentiful. And hey, the sun's coming up. Good timing. I can stash that in there, along with a signal. I don't know why a signal is a solid thing here, but whatever. Can I just eat this? Well, that didn't do any of our water levels any favors. Where's gonna be our best chance at bladderfish? Because we really need those. Way out, but out here. Where we need to go anyway? Please don't eat me, stalker. I mean you no harm, for real. I hear you. Ah, there's a bladderfish. Come here, you. Delicious. I thought the sun came up. I think we just came out of an eclipse. Oh, I hear, oh, that's not somewhere we want to go. I think we better make that flashlight, don't you think? Oh, that was an eclipse just now. Okay, that's cool. What the? I think that's a glitch. Seaweed just randomly floating in the air. Alright, now we have enough bladderfish to actually make some water, which is important so that we don't die. It's dull, I know, and it's not going out and getting, you know, creep vines or anything, but it must be done. So, staying hydrated is important both in-game and in real life, which is why I'm going to drink some coffee. Fun fact! And I will correct this in the YouTube comments if, in fact, this is not true. Last I heard, coffee actually makes you, slow your game, lady. I'm drinking already. They're driving me to drink. Coffee is a diuretic. It does make you urinate. But the amount of liquid lost from drinking coffee is about equal to that gained from drinking coffee. So it's a net neutral. That is what I have heard. I may issue a correction here. And if I do, this is where I'll put it. Okay, we done with the correction? No correction? Great, let's carry on. I don't need quartz. What I need are creepvine seeds. Please don't be a stalker here. No, there's a volcano here instead. Great. That is exactly what I needed. I actually do need to make another battery. What is that? Oh, that's more metal. Battery can come later. First, lubricant. That sounded like the beginning to a very fun night, honestly. Told you there would be sex jokes in this. Okay. Can we cook anything? Can we make anything? We're okay for power, actually. Lubricant! Can we make the mobile bay yet? Please, 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 please. Can we do this cool thing? Alright, I put those things in here. Let's see. One titanium ingot. One power cell. And a partridge in a pear tree. Let's make this thing. It's cool. Is there anything else that we can make right now? I do want the, laser cutter. We have diamond and we have titanium. Let's go ahead and make that while we're at it. I don't have it on me because I stashed it somewhere, but I do have titanium. So let's get some of that. And then, meant to go down, not up. Oh, fine. I'll come and get it in a minute. Release vehicle bay. I want to release it here. I want to release it in deeper water besides. Alright, fine. I will release vehicle bay. Let's do it out here. Alright. Mobile vehicle bay. Use vehicle bay. Vehicles! Seamoth. I need a titanium ingot. I can make that. I need a power cell and glass times two. You know what? I'm actually going to write that down, otherwise I'm going to forget it. Titanium ingot. We can make that. Power cell. We can make that. Glass times two. And lube. Okay. We're good. Let's go make that, I guess. After we get some... What else are we gonna get? Oh, right! Food and water. That's kind of essentials here. And we have been neglecting it. In our, haste to get places. Oh! Please vary your exercise for optimum... for uniform muscle development. I'm not swimming. I'm hanging onto this thing and it's pulling me. That's not well, actually it is kind of exercise. These things are, I've never actually used one, but if you've ever just tried hanging on while swimming, it's not insignificant. Just moving your limbs through the water actually can count as, you know, exercise. Fish. I don't remember this music. I think we've unlocked some new music somehow. It's nice. We're gonna need some of these if we're gonna make batteries. Oh, floaters! There's some crash fish down there. Don't want to go in there. Alright, let's see what we can find. Let's open our titanium locker, get some titanium out. After we get some oxygen into our lungs. Actually, we don't need to do that. That's a cooked boomerang. What's a cooked boomerang doing on the ground? Let's eat it. Oh, that's a rotten cooked boomerang, dang it. That would explain a lot. Can we cure anything? No. First, distill some filtered water, because we're going to need it. Cook a gary fish, because why not? And now... Oh, we don't need titanium for the battery, we need copper ore. I feel silly. It's beeping at us for a message. This offers are keen in LifePod 19. The captain is gone. I've assumed command. Dry land a kilometer south of the crash site. Stay together and regroup at the rendezvous point. Good luck. Okay. Cool. This message will now repeat. Transmission origin coordinates downloaded. So I guess we're supposed to go towards that? That'd be great if we knew where that was. Alright, what's in here? Let's go ahead and store some of the things we're gonna need. Take out some copper ore. Turn it into batteries. Because we're gonna need it whether we build a vehicle or whether we just go to this rendezvous point. Willing to bet there's nobody actually there anymore. But hey, maybe worth a shot! Need some... I kind of want to make a beacon, actually. So that we can find our way back to stuff later. Because right now that's a little bit tricky. How are we for pretty much everything? Right, we needed power cell. How do we make power cell? How do you make power cell? Two tank still suit. That's gonna be good. If we can only get that fiber mesh, dang it! Power cell, silicone rubber. Right! More creep vines. Okay. Message received, loud and clear. We need more. Let's cook a peeper. No, we don't get hungry while we're out. We can dump that. And, yeah, let's go. This is going to be an episode in which we make a lot of very short trips, I think. Don't need a rotten cooked boomerang. There are bubbles coming up from nowhere there. Our battery is at 10%. I don't want it to die while we're deep. Let's go ahead and switch that out. I think it's... There we go. Oh! Actually, that provides us a good that right there provides us an excellent opportunity for an animal science moment. Rabbit rays remind me of the an animal which we have here on Earth. It's called a nudibranch. There's a bazillion different varieties of nudibranchs out there. There's colorful ones and plain ones and big ones and little ones. And there's a stalker coming to get me. But one thing that a lot of nudibranchs do, I'm not 100% sure it's all of them, but a lot of nudibranchs will, when they reproduce, they do so by doing this thing, which biologists call penis fencing. It is exactly what it sounds like. Two nudibranchs, when will come in a reproductive state of mind, will, come across one another, and, they both have, reproductive organs on their bodies, which, functionally work like penises, and they will circle around each other and try to stab each other in the head with their penises. And this has the effect of injecting a whopping dose of sex hormones into the loser. And that winds up making them receptive to becoming basically the female of the pair. They're the one that will produce and carry the eggs. What were we doing? Oh, right, we were making some silicone rubber or lubricant? We can make a laser cutter now. Let's take to make. Let's make some silicone rubber, because then we can make a survival knife, and that's cool. Bleach. Where do we even get common coral samples? I don't know. Oh, now we can make the power cell, right? And, we're all out of creep vine seeds, so, let's go ahead and dump the power cell right in here. We're probably gonna need to make more batteries. Do we have enough materials for batteries? No, we don't, because we need copper freaking ore. Yeah, let's go ahead and get some copper ore next. Alright, this trip we're getting copper ore. I'm making a shopping list. Don't judge me. We're going to be getting some more creep vine. And I think that'll... And, of course, more bladderfish. Alright. We're good. Now that's better for the... That's rotten. We don't want that. If you find a random fish lying on the ground and the local bacteria haven't eaten it yet, that's a cooked boomerang. Is it rotten? Yes. Man, this planet is weird. The bacteria never decompose anything. Maybe there are no bacteria. That'd be weird. Also, it would make me question what all of the other life is eating. Don't do what I just did underwater. That's dangerous. Where should we go to find... Not that way. Find bladderfish. And copper ore. I swear there's new music now than there used to be. Oh yeah, because I also wanted a dive knife. And creep vine can help with that. Inventory full. Pull a creep vine. Not swimming over the volcanic vent. That is a bad idea. Should not be done. Do not antagonize the stalkers. That is also a bad idea. Any new messages now? Nope. Okay, fine. There's a med kit. We don't need it. What shall we? We don't need that. What we need is silicone rubber so that I can make a dive knife. Because that's cool. Weapons were removed from standard survival blueprints following the massacre on Obraxis Prime. The knife remains the only exception. Sorry about that. That's great. You know what? I'll make do with that. What is the laser cutter then? You can cut things with a laser. If you can cut metal with a laser cutter, you can cut flesh. What kind of nonsense is this? It's still twitching. That looks sad like this. And very slimy. Can we equip the survival knife? 1 to 5, quick. Let's see. Oh, we already have it. So we got that and... Okay, cool. I wonder what we can do with the survival knife. Let's go ahead and save now that we have it. Okay, so we have... We have the power cell. We need glass. What is it gonna... It's gonna take quartz to make glass, right? We have lubricant. And we need another titanium ingot. I know one of these here is full of quartz. Not that one. There's a quartz. Oh no, wait, that's the one I just took. Don't need those. There's all our quartz. Get rid of that. Can I cut things with the knife? Or stab things? Oh, you have to go and do tricks with it. Okay. Can I, like, cut some of the coral? Maybe that's how you get benzene, is cutting up these things, which I have said for, like, 4 or 5 episodes look like they should be able to yield blood oil. Yes! I am a machine of pure destruction now! Endless power. Can I make blood oil out of the sample, please? No. Can I cook the coral? No, I wouldn't think so. We'll cook the peeper instead. Okay. Glass. And not enough for more glass. Okay, fine. And lubricant. That's great. What do we have in our inventory? Go ahead and eat that. Contains trace precious metals used in computer fabrication. So can we distill it? Gold times 2, silver ore times 2. Table, oh there we go, table coral sample times 2. We have silver ore. We could totally get to work on making a computer chip. I think in here should be where we store our most precious stuff. Hey, we've already got glass in here. We don't need any more. Okay, let's see. We need glass times 2, lube, a power coil, and a titanium ingot. Now, what does it take to make a titanium ingot? Heck of a lot of titanium. Let's get that out. Power cell and lubricant. And, what else? More glass. I don't remember how much glass. Glass times 2. Good to have extras. Lead. Alright, let's make a titanium ingot. And now I think we can go ahead and fabricate that vehicle. Let's go do this. See what it gives us. Don't cut the mobile vehicle, bae. Vehicles! Sea moth! Let's do this. Swimming is fantastic for your glutes and endorphin levels. It's true! I don't have access to a pool right now. All the public pools are closed right now. Nice drones! Oh, cool storage room, too. Oh, pretty.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Oh. How fast can this baby go? Not half bad. Look at this. I'll bet your depth limit's not bad either. Can't pick up stuff while I'm in here. Yeah, it's probably not a good idea to take it into tight spaces. It's not a super shell. Oh, wow. The energy dies fast. Yeah, it would not have been a good idea to take my brand new submersible down there. Beautiful. Let's take you over to where we haven't been yet. Which way to the Aurora? And let's go away from that. We might actually be going towards the Aurora. We are. I just want to get to a place where there's new copper deposits, where I haven't been yet. I've pretty much mined out the area all around my, Yeah, I think we're pretty safe from radiation poisoning here. There's some nice, stuff to mine here. There's probably stalkers everywhere, but whatever. Oh! That turns out the lights. Okay. How do I get out? Exit E. Reading! There's a life pod over there. Forgot about that. Cut creep vine with knife? What majesty is this? Creep vine samples. That was a blueprint? Swim away! Swim away! Good, it didn't follow me. Alright, we're looking for... We used up a lot of quartz building that, so I guess it'd be good to have a few more. We're looking for bladderfish and copper samples. Also more things I can cut with the knife. Ooh, that's deep. Oh, there's that big hole I got distracted by the other week. No, sorry, that's not the big hole. This does look like the same kind of area, though. Gold. Very pretty. This looks like maybe something we can cut for blood oil. I just want blood oil, dang it! I want to be able to make benzene! Seeing any bladderfish around here. Oh well. Yeah, what the heck. We could use some more titanium. We used up a fair amount. Oh, there's the glowy ones. They don't like me a lot. Regular stalkers don't like me. These guys don't like me a lot. There's a bladderfish. Come here. Thank you. Inventory full. Oh, right, because I got this massive chunk of metal. Go away. You can't drink metal. Well, you can, but not with the... It would have to be molten, probably. And that's not good for the esophagus. Oh, I think those are the things which you're not supposed to get close to. Because they will suck you in and hypnotize you. I need more copper. What is the deal with the utter lack of any limestone? Am I just being blind? There's gotta be more around here somewhere. All I'm seeing is quartz, though. There's one. Thank you. Oh, those are manatees. Do not want. Let's pick up one more. Try to pick up one more bladderfish and then head to the sea moth. Oops, wrong way. Man, that's a cool looking thing. Can I stab you? Usually that's a bad sign. I think I just made it bleed, is all. Ooh, more gold. Gold is great, but I don't need it. I need copper. Let's get in here. And head on back. Back on home. Make some water. Make some batteries. Figure out what these creep vine samples do. Those are... Oh, shush. I'm inside a submarine now. Can they get me inside here? Huh. No. I am invincible! Hi, he's running away. Classic. I don't know what about that is classic, exactly. Basic materials. Fiber mesh at last! Excellent. Now we can start making progress towards all of the other things I've been wanting to make for forever. Okay. Ooh, we can make a rebreather. That's cool. That means we can stay underwater for a long time. In theory. Dive reel, very cool. What else can we do here? Oh, we can make our flashlight. Let's go ahead and do that. I'm sick of trying to do stuff in the dark. And we're gonna make a whole ton of filtered water while we're doing that. This is going to be dull, I apologize. Yeah, we're a little hungry too. Let's cook a whole fish. Alright. Is this quick equipped already? Now it is. Very good indeed. We're a little low on water, so... There we go. So the question becomes, what do we do now? We can make all this cool stuff with the computer chips and the wiring, but we don't really know what to do with it. I mean, I presume you can make some kind of bigger submarine? I've seen people driving around these huge submarines, so... Oh, that's what you do with the signals! We've already discovered life pods 17 and 6. Let's swap that out for the signal for life pod 4. Which is in one of these lockers somewhere. There it is. Go ahead and stash some of this random stuff in here too. Fiber mesh. Okay, yeah, this will be our assorted ingredients and signals thing. Golden signals. except an ampersand? Golden sig. That'll have to do. So, this begs the question. Where is this other life pod? All the way over there? Eh. I'm kind of curious. But does the Seamall take power cells or batteries?
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Let's find out. I'll bet it takes power cells. Before we go out exploring that far, I would like to make another power cell. That just seems like a good policy. Radiation suit. We can make a radiation suit. We can totally make a radiation suit. Let's do that first. Because I've been wanting a radiation suit for a long, long time. So we need 2 lead and 2 fiber mesh. We're gonna have to go get more creep vines for that fiber mesh. I know I've got more lead around here somewhere. There's one. Just sitting there. It's just hanging out. It's not even swimming. And there's a stalker, literally right there. Well, if I go down and up again fast enough, it won't hurt me. Please don't hurt me. Hey, bladderfish, it feels to me like they come out at night. What is that? Is that a dead bird? I think that's one of those bird things which we see flying around all the time. It looks like a ray. Like, it has, like, scales like a ray, and it looks like a ray, but it just fell dead out of the sky? That's not a good sign, if you ask me. Or maybe it's a bug. Kind of cool to see one up close, isn't it? What the... Oh, it's the light from my sea moth. I should probably turn it off so it's not draining the battery. Be nice if it was solar powered, but I guess not. Let's go ahead and make our radiation suit. I'm super excited for this. I've been working towards this literally since I started playing, except I couldn't figure out how to make the fiber mesh, and now I know. Let's get ourselves a radiation suit! Now we can get close to the aurora and not sustain massive damage. Radiation suit, radiation helmet, radiation gloves. We're wearing it all. It's beautiful. I noticed that this gets rid of our other oxygen tank. I do hope this won't be a problem. Okay, What were we going to do? We were going to make a power cell for our sea moth there. Let me remind myself of what that takes. I have the memory of a goldfish, which actually is not actually 3 seconds. Goldfish, I should point out, do actually have longer memories than that. They're not maybe the most bright of fish, but they're certainly capable of learning. Power cell. 2 batteries and silicone rubber. Do we still have lubricant? Do we still have the creep vine stuff? Rotten creep vine samples. Okay. Cool. Let's get some titanium and some acid mushrooms. Have we picked out the creep vines around here? I'm not really seeing any, Oh, there we go. So that'll do for the lubricant. Aha! Get here! Bladder fish, delicious! There's some titanium. Ooh. Now let's get out from over there. That would be bad if we died there. There has to be some incentive for going down in there. Otherwise it wouldn't be there. Ah! There's another bladderfish! Come here, you. And there's another stalker. Get away. Please and thank you. It's probably for crash fish galore down here. Or not. Maybe I'm just paranoid. There are outcrops I haven't picked up yet. Make some water here. Make some batteries. Good, and I can make silicone rubber. I don't know why I need silicone rubber to make. I guess for insulation, that would help. I'm trying to think of what role silicone rubber would play in actually making a power cell. Guess I need more titanium and more copper and more acid mushrooms. Let's go find some copper. Lucky for me, now that I have this radiation suit, I can wander off in any old direction and not really worry about it. Which way is this anyway? Is this way towards the Aurora? Kinda. And that'll help with it. Bladderfish! Come here, you! Just so desperate for water. Consume them all. I'm not going down there. And stop with the dramatic music. For starters. Lead, silver. Ah! Ah, dang it. breaking the surface does the trick. I don't know how to... I can never figure out how to get the bleeders off. Fortunately, I don't think I was carrying anything super important. No, not really. Hey, I kept my bladderfish even. Death has very little consequences in this game, really. Oh, I can cure a boomerang. That'll be handy for long-term travel. Make another battery. Hey, I can make another battery. I think that's the, Oh, no, wait. I still need copper. Dang creep vines always sheltering all the bleeders. Gotta be more careful about steering clear of those. What is that? Creature egg. Cool. There's an outcropping. There, copper ore! Yes! Excellent. Hear the volcanic rumbling nearby. I'll need a volcano. What I need is copper ore again. I'm not getting killed by a manatee. That would help. Do my ears deceive me, or do I hear the crackling of a... There you are. You know what I think I need to do to deal with the bleeders? I think I need to use my knife to try and cut them off. Next time I get attacked by one, that's what I'll try. Can I do anything to this rock with this knife? And some of these things have the green markings on them. If I didn't know better, I'd say that they had horrific radiation poisoning. What was that? Was that the you just backed into something noise, or the you are no longer suffering from radiation sickness poisoning, or beep, or... Oh, that's the you're out of battery beep. Well, that's why we're out here, to make more batteries. Because power... Oh, goodness, we're close to the Aurora. Because right now, power is our problem. At first, our problem was oxygen. And then it was, water, mostly. And now it's, finding enough materials for batteries. Wonder what happens if you kill these things. Probably bad things. Ooh! Brain coral sample. Oh, my inventory's full. Saw some of the manatee eggs. I assume they're eggs. I actually don't know if they're eggs or not. They certainly hurt you. Which actually, in the worst segue ever, brings me to another animal whose Valentine's Day mating habits I wanted to talk about. They're not actually Valentine's Day mating habits. They mate this way all the time. It's an animal which hurts us a lot. It's called a blood fluke. It lives in a cycle between, humans and snails. I'm just cycling through, not really knowing what I'm doing here. Let me concentrate for a second. electronics, batteries, and we can make a power cell now. That'd be great. Fine and dandy. We still need more batteries, though, to be honest, because otherwise our sea glide isn't going to work, so we need more copper. Fine day out. So, yeah, blood flukes, their life cycles between snails, which live underwater, and humans. And when they get into humans and infect them, the consequences are not pretty. They can cause infections in your bladder and intestines and just kind of make your life hellish for a while. This is pretty common. It's not common here because we don't have in North America because we don't really have the snails. Which host it. Also, it's just not common here in the first place. Ah, here we are. Nice big tube with dead fish on it. Oh, I guess I was here before then. Got some lead. But the mating habits thing, but unlike most of the worms of its type, the blood fluke actually has two sexes instead of just being male and female hermaphroditic all in one. I'm gonna dump that. Hope it doesn't hatch on me. Drop that. The blood fluke actually has both male and female sexes. And what happens is when the two of them find one another, inside of a person, the male coils himself around the female, and she can quite happily live inside sort of a pocket on his side for the rest of her days. And he will basically provide her with the nutrients she needs, and he will fertilize her eggs. And then they make lots of more blood fluke babies, which then eventually wind up back in snails and then back in humans, and the cycle of infection happens all over again. Do I have enough copper yet? I do. Do I have enough mushrooms yet? No. One of these days I'm going to regret picking the ones right underneath my pod. This is the Carrar virus infection? Is that a reference to a real-world disease that I'm not familiar with? Or is this a reference to a game? Because that's not something that I recognize. But then I am not an expert on infectious diseases. Although I do spend a lot of my time working on them, but I would not call myself an expert. Okay. So I got a new battery. That's good. I got some cooked fish. I got some filtered water. I'm gonna go grab a, grab another fish for dinner so I can cook it. Get back here. Because I'm currently a little bit hungry. Actually, a lot bit hungry. Fortunately, there are fish all over the place, and I don't have to expend too much time or energy doing that. We'll just wait out the night cooking some things and eating some things, and then we can go and check out that life pod. And that'll be a good thing, I think. Cook the Gary fish. This always reminds me of a mudskipper, you know, with its eyes like up on the top of its head like that. Mudskippers don't actually really do that, but I don't know. There's something ineffably mudskipperish about it to me. And what the heck, we'll leave our brain coral behind because we don't need it right now, but we might later. Same with copper and the lead and all this random titanium. We don't need it. Honestly, if we just dump it right here, it'll be waiting for us. It's not going anywhere. It's gonna in the Sea Glide and head over to the other life pod. That's not the Sea Glide. What am I saying? This thing I'm holding is a Sea Glide. That's my pod. And my sea moth is right there.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Why, thank you. Let's head out. Just tootling along. Oh! Hi, Reefback! I presume that's what that is. I don't want to ram you with this thing. But my, you're pretty. Oh, I actually had a cool theory about the Reefbacks the other day. Which, checking this one out might help confirm. Ooh. Can get a good look at the motion on it. So, well, I guess it doesn't really hold up because those things on the front kind of twitch too. Yeah, never mind, my theory doesn't hold up at all. I had a crazy theory that maybe the Reefbacks had this kind of cool, ooh, sand shark too, life cycle where they spend some time on the in some of those really deep holes like that one we found last time. And then they break off and drift upwards to their pelagic lifestyle like we see here. Man, there's a lot of them. Ooh, moon's lit up green. I don't think I've seen them quite so active with the tendrils before. They are very active right now. But, and I was thinking, you know, the tendrils kind of look like roots a little bit. And that would kind of fit with that idea. But, then I thought, probably not. I don't know if I hold with that theory anymore. They are pretty though, aren't they? Let's eat something. There's the Aurora. I don't really want to approach the Aurora itself. It's on the south side of the Aurora, he said. Oh, I can kind of see it from here. I don't want to do that in the dark. That thing scares me a little bit. Let's go parallel to it. How far are we away from home, anyway? Not that far. I don't think we can get to it from here. We'd have to go all the way around. Pecking a faint Altera technology signals. Yeah, the Aurora is right frickin' there. Well, I want to explore the Aurora, but I also want to get to this life pod. But I also don't want to do this until the sun rises, quite frankly. Let's go around it. Hi, Reefax. Oh, I saw a shooting star. There was supposedly a comet visible last night. Or not necessarily even last night, but ooh, something looming in there. But a couple nights ago, I did not get my act together to go and see it, though. It was cloudy here. Oh, hey, Reefax. You are getting irradiated like crazy, aren't you? Oh, there's a whole pod of you. That's ominous music. I can't frickin' see what's going on. So I'm gonna head away from the Aurora and up to the surface. And now, fortunately, the sun is up. That is super ominous music, and I'm definitely not equipped with anything better than a dive knife. How far away from the Aurora are we? And from that dive pod. We're actually quite a ways away from the pod, too. Oh, cool. What is that? Is this where the reef packs grow? This actually looks kind of glitchy. Like, things are not necessarily connected to one another. If I didn't know better, I'd say these were baby reef backs. That looks like something we can mine. That looks cool. What are those? This is a whole new biome we've never gotten to explore before, mostly because the radiation's too bad. Alright. I wonder what that is. I want to scan all these things. Never mind the Aurora. This stuff is sweet. These tree-like things. Ooh. Oh, more floaters. These ones are like turquoise. Wonder what happens if I get out here. If I get out of the pod 100 feet, meters down, am I gonna regret it? You know what? Let's get out of the Aurora the sea moth close to the surface and see what happens when I dive down. How deep can I go? It's a good thing decompression sickness isn't a thing. 100 meters before it starts giving me problems. Rue cluster. Wonder if hacking at any of this tree leech. I think that gave me samples. Tree mushroom. Whoa! I hacked the whole thing off! I didn't mean to do that! No, did I just kill a baby reef back? You know what? Scanning all this stuff should help. Oh, apparently I have a new message. Searching. There! Tree leech. Where'd my sea moth go? That's the thing they tell you about diving. Too easy to get disoriented. Oh, there it is. Man. Get up to the surface, get another round of oxygen. Because this is totally how scuba tanks work, but never mind. Get back to the sea glide. You know what? That life pod doesn't have anybody in it anyway. It can wait. Let's explore along the seabed while heading back home. Clear a path between here and there, see what happens. Because this biome's cool, but I don't really know what necessarily is in it for us. I mean, there's some lithium growing on the sides. I think that's what that is. Then there's a sharp drop-off here. Which may or may not be what we've seen before. Let's see here. This is starting to look like familiar territory. Whoa, what was that? Ha ha ha, you can't get me. I think that's a sand shark, actually. I am invincible! Actually, the health on this thing went down. That's what repair tools are for. This is cool. Have we been in here before? I don't think we have. Unfortunately, there's tons of sand sharks around. And they don't like me much. I'm tempted to get out and scan stuff, but I think I would probably die. Yeah, my health on the sea moth is already down to 85%. Oh, shush. There is, in fact, scannable stuff in there. Until I get some kind of projectile weapon. Ooh. Then I don't think I'd be coming back here. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna get out and see if I can just sort of swim in there real quick. That looks like a hatch that is openable. Apparently not. Maybe with a laser cutter. That is a bad sound. Maybe the wreck itself is collapsing. We'll get out the repair tool once we're back at base. See if we can't patch this thing up a little bit. Sand sharks. Gotta love them. One of these days, I'll figure out how to get where blood oil comes from. Look where you're going! Jeez, I am not some soft, fleshy thing. I'm made of metal. There's metal all around your environment. I don't know what you don't understand about this concept. Yay, refax! You're so pretty. What happens if you hit me with your tentacle? You narrowly miss me like the gentle giant that you are. How noble. I'm gonna get out and grab some of these, or I'm not because my inventory is full, I think? I think that's what's going on here? Nope, I just missed. While we're going back, I may as well talk about one of the other animals I had prepared for today. Reefbacks! No, just kidding. That was last episode. So actually, you know what? This reminds me. Right whales. There are a bunch of different whales which have fascinating mating habits, which I could go on about for a very long time. They're all different, though. Whales have varying different mating habits and courtship customs. Like, everybody knows about whale song, you know? That would be humpback whales have this courtship song, which varies from year to year. And you can actually kind of watch trends get passed between whales as certain songs become more and less popular throughout the ocean. What just happened? What did I just hit? I think I got out of it while it was still moving. That's a flashlight. I think this is the repair kit. Yeah, there we go. Patch you right up. Very good. Let's go again and get some health and food and drink. I even got a new message. Let's do that first. Life pod 13. Emissary Jochi Kazar. I said Jochi Kazar. Why do I have to record this anyway? Send immediate burial detail. Aww. That's too bad. He didn't make it. Nice thing about needing to have so much filtered water in game, it helps me keep hydrated here. IRL. I think I forgot to pick up any actual fish. Just a ton of platter fish. Well, Let's get hydrated then. I can dash out and grab some actual fish real quick. Or maybe I can't because I've picked that out too. I'm not seeing a ton of actual non-bladderfish fish. Except peepers, and they're too fast. Get back here! Ooh! Copper ore, yes! Need some more batteries. Not seeing any stalkers. Man, that's beautiful. Like the kelp forest in real life. That is my sign to get out of here. The roar of the stalker. And the volcano really should have taught me not to go venturing into random crevices already. But I do it anyway. That is a crashfish. That is a thing I will not tangle with. I'm smarter than that. Peepers. Yeah, so, humpbacks. Like I said, they have these songs that they transmit throughout the ocean. It's mostly the... Ooh. What's a reef back doing in so close to shore? I wonder. They sing to attract the females. Which usually works. Different kinds of whales have, and dolphins, I should say, because they're all cetaceans, have different courtship methods or lack thereof. Male dolphins in particular are, it's gonna get a little weird, but male dolphins are actually, not the nicest of animals, shall we say. The young males often travel in their own pods. Pins, radiation suit. I could make a still suit, but I like my radiation suit. What does it take to make a wiring kit? Oh, okay, so in order to make rebreathers, it's gonna take a heck of a lot of silver. Fortunately, I know where to find that. Mm-hmm. Let's eat some things first, though. I love these medical kit fabricators. It's basically endless health. It's fabulous. Yeah, I don't know how dark we should get with this exactly, but, ooh. Which way is towards the aurora? That one is in the opposite direction of the aurora. Let's go do that. Let's go see that one. Where's my sea moth? Where are you? Oh no, that is towards the aurora. There we go. Yeah, male dolphins, like I mentioned, will often travel in pods, kind of all but by themselves, not with any females. And if they do come across female dolphins, they will, what humans would term, assault them to have sex with them. That's not pretty. Actually, a lot of underwater mammals have some habits which, by human standards, are pretty abhorrent. Natural mating habits of sharks. I have alluded a couple of times on this show to the mating habits of sharks, which I happen to know something about because I spent a couple weeks one summer working on a project in which I was examining the cartilage inside the, I guess the shark equivalent of a penis for dogfish sharks. I don't like doing this at night. Should be right there, like visibly there. I guess there's nothing to illuminate. At a reef back or the ground? Ooh, that's the ground. Pretty. Let's go down and see. Hey there! Welcome to the chat. I was just talking about shark penises. If you want me to talk about something else, I'd be more than happy to do so, but I can, describing my, summer working on, a particular science project. This is really cool looking, but I can't really see what's going on at this, after dark. We'll come back to this once it's a little lighter. Where'd that pod go? That's quite far away. We should be right on top of it. Oh, we passed it! That's why. So why can't I see it? It's up in the air. Why can't I see it? Well, I'm just gonna sit here and wait for lights to return to the sky because by all rights, it's right in front of me and I'm not seeing it. And I'm thinking either it's just not loading or maybe it'll load once the sun comes up. This was the send burials squad thing, so maybe we'll just come across a body? It's just too dark to see. And that's a pretty sight. The moon roiling in the distance. Rolling, not roiling. You can kind of see the stars through it, which is a little disconcerting, but what the heck? Either it sank, drifted away, or got towed, pushed away. By what, though? I came to it pretty much right away, I would think. Also, what would tow it away? Unless the aliens are still active. It didn't give me that impression, but... Well, maybe with the lights on, then we'll be able to get some better idea of... Yeah, there's nothing here. That's a pity. Maybe it sank. That's entirely possible. We'll go down and look for it in a minute. Now that the lights are on, ooh, we're in another of these biomes. I like this one. I can't really fathom the usefulness of it to us, but it is pretty cool looking. These giant mushroom trees. Oh, there's a cave. Not gonna try to take the sea moth in there. That would be a bad idea. I hear a reef back. I like those ray things. I wish I could get close enough to scan one, but I think they're a little too deep for me to be outside of the sea moth and not get crushed. I I don't want to approach crushed death. Oh, that's so pretty. Plus, they look like they might sting, to be perfectly honest. Fluorescent. How long would it take the damaged pod to sink? Well, I guess that means that depends on how many holes there were in it. You know, the faster, if water had a straight path into it and air couldn't get trapped in the top, then it would probably sink pretty fast. But in any case, I'm not really seeing it. Seeing some plants I don't recognize. Oh, I recognize these plants. What am I talking about? They are really pretty, but, it's still showing us being up there on the surface. Very quiet here. I would have expected more reef backs somehow. It could in fact be that the pod is here, it's just not loading. I have had problems with that before, especially recently. Where things just weren't loading the way they should. So maybe next game, once I've had a chance to stop and reload, I'll come back and check it out again. I am awfully tempted to see what's beyond this, though. Let's go see what's beyond this. We've still got well over half our energy. I hear a reef back. Show yourself, reef back! Casting that shadow, I wonder. Oh, this thing. Ah. There's the reef back. That's a new call. Sounded like an elk. Let's talk about elk for a minute. Elk are cool. Elk definitely have some fun mating habits. Every fall, they go into this thing called the rutting season, when they, do this, just look around in the mushroom forest. I'll go back and do that later. Elk have this, go into rut every fall, where they, the males will make these, weird wailing cries. Oh, this one has one of these things on it. I can never figure out what these are all about. I have a knife now. Let's get out and try to cut that thing. See if that does anything. I might die. Rogue cradle seed. Rouge cradle seed. Not rogue. Break barnacle. That. I'm just going nuts with the knife these days. What is that? I say that a lot with the knife. What is that and can I cut it? Redwort seed. Man, I'm just picking up seeds for all of these. I don't know what I'm gonna use them for. But, now my inventory is full of them. I'm just gonna drop some of these. I can't imagine I can really do that much with them at this point. And I can pick up more if I need to.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Oh, there's another reef back. Hello, reef back. We are going away. Yes? Yes. We are continuing to travel away from home. Just to see what's out there. I don't want to get too deep. Oh, there's a bone shark. I think that's what those things are called, right? Some cool flora on the bottom, but I can't get too deep. Don't want my poor sea moth to suffer damage. Something is roaring at me. I think it's that thing. I wonder if there's up upgrades you can get for your sea moth to make it able to withstand greater pressure. I'm sure there are. I know there's a console command. I'm pretty sure there's a console command. But, passing safe depth. But I don't want to pass the safe depth. I don't want to be crushed by pressure. It's cool that they do have pressure as a game mechanic, though. That's fun. Are we undergoing the daily eclipse, or am I just down too deep? I think I'm just down too deep. We're in deep water now. Cool. It even sounds like it. See, if I actually heard that in real life inside a submarine, I'd get worried because that sounds like the sound of water coming in. I'm gonna head back, I think. There isn't much we can reach it without something that can go deeper at this point anyway. What is that? That looks like a chunk of wreckage stuck on top of the mushrooms. Pretty sweet. And it is just on the edge of what we can tolerate. And I don't have my laser cutter yet. So I can't get in there unless there's a hatch. There is a hatch. And I can't get in there either. Take note of this, though. I'll be back. Yes. I never finished talking about elk. So yeah, during the fall, the males will undergo intense battles with one another, locking horns and making these deep bellowing noises. There was this photo that was circulating during the best carcass thing on Twitter. Oh, floaters. Which showed an elk that had obviously gotten into a fight with another elk, and one elk lost and died, but the elk that died still had his antlers locked, stuck with the still living elk. So apparently, somehow, the still living elk ripped off the head of his dead rival and was wandering around with the dead elk head still stuck to his antlers. I don't know exactly how he was able to survive for very long like that, but the picture was, as far as I could tell, legitimate, so. There's that. Ooh. You know, I've never gotten up close and personal with the creepvine roots before. That's because stalkers keep attacking me. Bet bleeders aren't gonna do much to me either. Ha! Yeah! Bump against me. That's gonna do a lot of damage. I hate bleeders. I actually need to grab something really quick, if you don't mind. My laptop cord fell out. Hey, stop dive bombing me. What did I ever do to you? Oh, I killed it! It's drifting to the surface. Here, stalker, come and eat it. You'll love it. I should stop causing such wanton destruction with this thing. Here we are back again. Back in shallow water, safe and sound. to go exploring the Aurora, but for in order to do that, I really should have a laser cutter. Which I do not have. Let's get out. A second here. No more messages. Get a new first aid kit. It's always good to have as many of those as possible. Can we cook any food? No. Because we don't have any, right? And we didn't pick up any bladderfish on the way back. How short-sighted. Status is okay. Let's see if we can figure out how to replace the power cells on this thing. Oh, okay. Ooh, I want to try something. Can we charge the power cells in these slots? No. I don't want to eat the cured whole fish. Let's go on another food run. Well, we can. Well, we're back here in the shallows and not doing anything particularly fascinating. Come here, you. Whole fish. Get back here. Yeah, I guess my point about elk was that elk are pretty wild. Pretty wild as far as their mating habits go. Is this another volcanic vent? No, no, this is another... This is another super deep death hole vent. Do not want. Not right now. There's no bladderfish down there. There's one. The manatee is bellowing at some kind of mating call. I doubt it, though. Because they do it constantly. Of course, they are constantly releasing those egg sacs. So, you know. What do I know? Maybe it is. Maybe they're just permanently in mating season. Have I explored this wreckage? Yeah, I have. Just some titanium. Ooh! Come here! And you too! Get back here! I want to eat you! Thank you! There's those birds again. I wonder what caused them all to fall down here, anyway. Earlier in the episode. Cook a Gary fish. Cook peeper. Cook whole fish. Distill bladderfish. You know, I never finished talking about sharks, did I? Actually, mating in sharks varies a lot by species, actually. But most sharks, it's not pretty. Let's just say that one of the ways that shark biologists can tell if any given shark is male or female is if they have a lot of bite marks on their fins. let's get some of this titanium out and make another storage locker. We got so many storage lockers, but we need it. What'll happen in a lot of shark species is that the male will basically chase down the female until she's extremely tired. Inventory full. Right. Yeah, at which point he will grab onto her fin and try to hold her in place while he mates with her. This has the unfortunate effect of causing her, and usually the male as well, to be unable to breathe. Because a lot of shark species, you know the old saying about sharks need to keep moving or they'll drown? That's kind of true, honestly. They need to have constant water flow over their gills, or they will not be able to get oxygen from the water. Oh dear, this old inventory full problem again. Does one have any space? It has one space! That's fine, I'll take it. So yes, basically the male shark will hold the female shark down and mate with her while she is unable to breathe. And then when they're both on the point of drowning, then he'll let go and swim off. Also, male sharks don't have penises per se. What they have is a thing called the clasper, which is like a... frankly, it looks kind of like one, except they have two of them. And Gold and Sig just bobbing up and down out there. That's... looks amusing to me. And, still inventory full! Come on, my inventory's not full. This is that bug again. You won't be surprised till I drop... You won't be satisfied till I drop everything, will you? We'll get more Rouge Cradle seeds. Ah! Nope! Battery! Come back! I don't want to lose you. There we go. Take that out. Where's the locker? There we go. No, I didn't want to pick it up again, silly. Great. So, I guess the next thing we want to make in-game, try to work towards, is the laser cutter. We need the laser cutter and, then we'll be able to cut into some of those wrecks, I think. Propulsion cannon. That would be useful, actually, for trying to push away enemies. Just me, or is the world moving a bit? I think it's this thing. Ooh, and habitat builder would be pretty sweet. Let me run down the list here. Compass! That would be super handy. Beacons. Grav sphere. I'm open to suggestions as what I should make next, but I think honestly the laser cutter should be our next option. And you know what? We have a battery, somewhere we've got a diamond, and we've definitely got titanium, so let's find where we put that diamond, shall we? It's around here somewhere, just gotta find out which locker I put it in. Definitely need titanium for this. Kelp seeds. It won't be in there, I don't think. There is some random silver in there, which I don't even know. There's the diamond. Laser cutter, here we come. Tools. Yes. Very good. Let's take a look at our inventory. We got two bottled waters. Could really use another cured fish if we're gonna go out long term. Life pod 4 and life pod 13. Wasn't there another life pod that we found that we couldn't get into for whatever reason? Well, that may have solved that. Let's see what it is. Life pod 3! Oh yeah, the one we couldn't get into before. I'll swap that out for one of the life pod signals that we couldn't get into before. Let's do that one. Alrighty. Life pod. There we go. Let's head out to that one. That'll be a fun time, I think. Pick up some fish while we're out. It'll be great. How far away is life pod 3? I know it's the one in the opposite direction of the... Hang on. There's one really far away. And then there's that one. I think it's that one. Let's hop in and head out. Hello, beepers. You will be my lunch later. Hello, stalker. Someday I'll figure out how to kill you. And take your teeth, because I know your teeth are collectible, are an item in this game, so they must be useful for something. Sand shark egg. Lost track of the buoy. Are they both in that direction? I thought that buoy was behind me. Oh well. That's what I get for not paying attention. Let's head straight for it. Also, I know this is life pod 3 because we actually found it before that one time. And we ignored it because we had better things to do at the time. Hi, stalker. Okay, that was a whale song. Whoop. Yeah, you were trying to get your nose into it. I remember that. Let's get in here. Scan. Can you scan any of this? Is there any? There's a stalker right frickin' there. Oh, there's a data pad right there. Let's hop back into the... Where did the sea moth go? I literally parked it right there. Oh, it's right there. I parked it a little too far up. Let's check out the contents of that data pad real quick. Data downloads. Data pads. Operations logs. Scattered wreckage. Public documents. We found this earlier. Today, the Mongolian states is seen as a relatively minor power on the... Quit it, stalker! Leave me alone. On the outskirts of colonized space, yet it remains one of the fastest expanding transgovs in the galaxy. Little civilized control. Non-synthetic foods remain popular. Cool. Ion crystals. I haven't looked at any of this stuff in a long time. actually tells you. Sea moths take... Oh, you can have modules. Cool. These modules may only be manufactured at a appropriately outfitted moon pool. I guess we gotta make a moon pool then. Definitely don't have the capacity to do that yet. Reinforced dive suit. Why take chances when you can take Altera? Well, we did that, and that crashed. So, that's not so great. But still suit, because drinking reclaimed urine is better than death by rehydration. This is absolutely the case. What do you think astronauts do? Most of the water on the space station, I don't know about most, a lot of the water on the space station is recycled. Life pods, anonymous crew log. Operations logs, alien data. I could go through all this later, so everybody watching the stream is in bored to tears. Let's see here. There's this trench here. That's pretty cool. I don't think there's really anything scannable in there besides... I didn't see anything scannable in there besides the data pad. Be far enough away that I can get up, nip out and get this? Yeah. Silver. Cool. Oh, there's one of those mind thingies. Don't want that. By mind thingies. Yep. Not having any of that. Does it still affect me if I am in here? Apparently not. It keeps hitting me. I think I might have been bumping against the sides here. See, that thing is cool. This area is cool, but I also know that those hypnotic things live down there. I can't deal with those. Are you gonna attack me or what? I guess not when I'm in. Whoa! What was that? Oh, yeah, you are gonna attack me. Not gonna do much, though. It didn't take any damage. Alright, this is by the way back out to the island. Oh, quiet, you sharks. I'm not gonna hurt you. I wonder. This continental shelf kind of thing. What happens if I follow it down to my crush depth? Can I see anything down here? More floating islands. Ooh, you can kind of hear crackling noises.
Caution. Passing safe depth.
Ooh, this was a good choice. Unfortunately, I can't get out here without a reinforced suit, I don't think. That looks like it contains something. And the game is not happy that I'm going this deep. It is freezing and glitching a lot. There's definitely scannable stuff in here, but, I can't get out or I'd die. I have to remember this. Keep looking for wreckage in shallower waters. Because that's what we can get to right now. I might try getting the habitat building module up and running. Oh, there's the island. Certainly a lot more accessible now. With this. cool. It's like a path leading up to it. You know, let's go check out the underwater portion of the alien facility as long as we're here. Because we have the capacity to now. Because we can go down this deep. Ooh, what is this? This looks inviting. Perhaps a little too inviting. Ah. See, ordinarily I wouldn't be able to get out here because there's all those biting things, which... Case in point. If I get out here, am I gonna die? Oh, shush, fish. I might. I think I would, honestly. Yeah, because my maximum depth as a diver without a reinforced suit is 100 meters, and we're at 113 right here, so... Not going to die! I'm just gonna keep coming around the side of this island here. There's a bone shark. Couple more bone sharks. Whoa! Get out! You're not hurting me. There's another cave. Again, I don't think I can fit in there. When I have the reinforced suit, I'll come back and explore this properly. I don't even have the blueprints for it yet. Last time I saw this, it was in the dark. It's a little less intimidating in the daylight, but not by much. Doesn't look like it goes all that deep. Whoa! Either those are one of the aliens, or they're an apparition created by them. What the? What was that? Did you just shoot at me? Yeah, my health went down. Look at that. You don't like me. They remind me a little bit of Illithids from Dungeons & Dragons, which is weird because Illithids have actual squid for faces. Like Cthulhu style. But, what happens if I pull this in here? Nothing, apparently. I wonder if this counts as a designated moon pool. Probably not. I need to stop and have a drink here. Getting a little dehydrated. A little hungry. Guess let's start heading back. Once we have some kind of a... If we built a base out here, like if we had the capacity to do that, that would extend our range so much. That'd be pretty cool. New goal! Figure out what this is. And then get back in there because that music is ominous. And I can't click it. What is that? That is big. That was huge. I think I would not like to tangle with it at this point in time. Cool, it's like a path leading up the side of the mountain, only underwater. I just jumped out of the water. That is great. You know, I wonder if the creatures on this planet have anything like real life coral spawning. There's plenty of coral like creatures on this planet, for sure. Get back here! So it wouldn't be surprising to me, really. There's a phenomenon that happens here on Earth where, coral polyps, which are the tiny little organisms which make up the coral itself, are able to coordinate their spawning times. All these tiny little creatures are able to release their eggs and sperm at the exact same time, despite being basically, you know, tiny little invertebrate things. It's quite beautiful to watch, just this clouds of life, basically. It's just as you're, I haven't seen it personally, but I've seen footage of people swimming around and videoing this. I have heard, I will confirm this before putting it online, that, have I checked this wreck? Yeah, I have. I don't think I was able to cut it open, though. Well, I have a laser cutter now. Laser cutter. Cut open to access. Yes, there we go. We're gonna get into this wreck, guys. It's gonna be great. Yeah, no, coral are able to, keep track of the phases of the moon, and that plus temperature is able to tell the individual polyps when to spawn. It's important that they all spawn at the same time. It keeps resetting on me. 57%, 61%, or else, because the whole point is that they all spawn at once. If only one coral spawned, then you'd have a bit of a problem, because there wouldn't be anything for it to connect to, really. Wouldn't be any of the other corals for it to be mated with. Oh, I think I have to follow it all the way around. I'm running out of oxygen. I think it's glitching. Yes! There we go! Scanner. Bench! I can make a bench! Ooh. Is that it? No signal. I can't interact with that at all? All that worked for a bench. I am mildly disappointed. Well, there are other wrecks to cut open, certainly. And we will. In time. There's Life Pod 3. Did we need to cut that one open? No. We took care of that one. We took care of that just fine. They're such beautiful animals. Annoying as heck, because they're so ferocious. But beautiful. No, you can't come in, even if you knock nicely. I'm gonna hop out and grab some of these bladderfish right here. Because we are running a little low on water and food. Not much, just a little low. I don't want to tangle with you. The volcanic vent? I don't want to find out. Let's see. What have we talked about? We've talked about elk. We've talked about coral. We haven't talked about the real-life lovebirds, have we? There was a study out... Hello again, it's me, Bird, coming back to you with another correction, because when Elizabeth says lovebirds here, she does not actually mean lovebirds. She means the blue-capped cordon bleu. There is a link to a video of these birds, which are actually finches, not lovebirds, which are a different kind of bird. There is a link in the video description to them singing and dancing and doing their thing, and when you slow them down, they sound like dinosaurs. How cool is that? This is likely the last time I will be making the correction because I am a taxidermied bird, and, I was stuffed by Elizabeth and am therefore not the sturdiest specimen and not accustomed to this kind of abuse. But in the meantime, please remember this correction. Thank you, and enjoy the video. Lovely. There was a study out, I think it was last year, about actual lovebirds, and which is an actual species of birds, not just a metaphor. That's splashed. I think that was me. When they are undergoing their courtship, scientists used to think that they just did these little hops to impress one another. But it's actually a lot more complex than that. Turns out, in order to impress one another, lovebirds will do a little tap dance. Instead of just doing a hop up and down, they will hop and they will patter their feet on the branch as they do so, to make a little rhythm. Scientists only found this out by basically slow-mo filming the lovebirds as they were courting one another, which I think is pretty cool. So much of the world's life lives at such a faster pace than we do. Alrighty, so what do we need in order to really advance? We need a reinforced dive suit, but we don't have the ingredients for that. Could use a compass, could use a thermometer. We don't really need a thermometer. What is it gonna take to make that habitat? Habitat manufacturer, because that would be pretty cool if we could start making some other buildings. Habitat builder, there we go. We need a computer chip and a battery. Batteries are easy. Those are a dime a dozen. For a computer chip, though, we're gonna need, where's my electronics? A table coral sample times two. I'm writing my shopping list here. We're gonna need a silver ore and a quartz. So these are all easy to get. So let's go get them. We don't even need to take the sea moth. We can just use our sea glide. Super easy. Table coral, literally right there. Can even make a couple. Quartz, where is quartz? I know that's around here too. It's just a matter of finding where it's gotten to. And not merging right in the middle of either. Ha! Stalker on one side, manatees on the other. Pick your poison. I'm gonna take my chances out this side. There's a quartz. Let's go make a computer chip. Actually, you know, let's see if we can find the ingredients for two. As long as we're here. And some dinner. There's another quartz. Easy. And what was the other thing we needed for this? Battery. Well, we all know battery means copper ore, so... But we get gold instead! I'm not complaining. 30 seconds. Thanks. We're gonna need a new battery for this thing anyway soon. How far can we get in here before a stalker picks us up? Copper! Excellent. Salt's gonna be good. We can cure one of those fish we picked up. Music. You had to go and cut it off, didn't you? I'm just trying to catch one of these peepers. Whoa! Jeez! Alright, I'm going. Oh, speaking of songs, there's one animal I haven't talked about yet with a cool courtship ritual. Peacock spiders! If you're not familiar with peacock spiders, I highly recommend looking for a video. I'm actually going to go try and put an annotation right here, if I remember. If I don't, I'll put it in the video description. Because peacock spiders are pretty awesome. There's a lot of different varieties. A peacock spider out there in the world. Most of them are from Australia, or New Zealand, or that part of the world. They are tiny. They can fit on your thumb. They're like, you know, tiny, tiny. But the male peacock spiders are very brightly colored, generally. Let's make a computer chip! Exciting! Very high tech. We gonna do with it? Oh, yeah. Habitat builder. And now we need a battery. We need more freaking copper ore. Oh, we need acid mushrooms. Let's go get those. Like I said, dime a dozen. But one of the reasons that the male peacock spiders are so flamboyant is because when they approach a female peacock spider, they raise their brightly colored abdomens up in the air, kind of like a peacock spreads its tail, and they waggle those abdomens back and forth, and they shake them very rapidly. Actually, also kind of like a peacock. Peacocks do that too, just not quite so dramatically. And it depends on the species, but most peacock spiders will also raise either one or both of their front limbs in the air, and often they've got like white spots on the end, so it looks like they're wearing white gloves, and they will wave their arms in some complicated pattern. Maybe they'll wave them one side and then the other, or they will beckon and beckon again, and as they're doing their little tail waggling hand waving dance, they will vibrate whatever branch they are on at the same time. Can I make my habitat builder? Yes! Excellent. Let's see if we can go outside and see what we can wield. So yeah, they're vibrating the ground at the same time to create a song of sorts, to go in time with their dance. Now, we can't hear it. Let's see. Oh, my battery's almost dead. Why? Let's go use it to go find some more copper, shall we? Because otherwise, we'll be stuck. Oh, hi, Reefback! You wouldn't happen to know where all the copper is, would you? Oh, I actually have a communique. If I can't get more copper, I will be stuck. I think I have another, I have one more piece of copper back at the habitat. They're so pretty. Just alien whales doing their thing. Yes, copper! Pick up a couple of these and head back. We'll need more, of course, but this'll do for now. This'll get us the battery so that we can go get more copper ore. Now we have to decide where else we wanna make our where we want our second habitat to be. I think of good ways away from this so that we can expand our range a bit. Alright, first battery, then we get the message. First we cook the Gary fish. Then we make the battery, then we get the message. Very good. Altera crew, this is Life Pod 7, updating our coordinates. Don't go home without us. Seriously, 7 out. Well, that means there's somebody out there still alive, somehow. Well, we can't exactly leave, can we? We just get shot down. Anybody who tries to is going to. You know, now that we have the sea moth, I've half a mind to just go all the way around the Aurora. See if we can make it the long way around. Get some supplies. I'm very tempted. So there's Life Pod 3. We found that. Let's replace it with a signal from Life Pod 7. Yeah. That'll do. And you know what? Let's see what this habitat builder can do. I can see the sun is setting. Habitat builder. Ah, nope, don't drop it. I just spent all that work. Okay. Habitat builder. laser cutter, habitat builder. There we go. Oh, there we go. That's what I like to see. Okay, now all that titanium is going to come in super handy. All right. So, hit points. Oh, for to withstand the pressure. Okay. I don't see a moon pool here. But you know what? I like this. I like this a lot. Exterior modules, floodlights, base attached air pump. That's cool. I guess you have to have air pumps to get air down into your base. Solar panel, interior modules, communications late relay. Oh, we can make our own fabricator now! This is most excellent. Wall locker? That's going to be important. Battery charger? I want that very much. Ooh. It's a little redundant to have an aquarium when you've got the whole world outside your door, really. Well. Ooh, a bioreactor. We found a lot of these. Chair. Surprisingly comfy. Oops. Yeah, I guess the clock's ticking while we're looking at all the cool stuff we can build, isn't it? Well, so I have a proposal. It's getting kind of late here, IRL, so to speak. So next time on the show, next time we play Subnautica, so it's going to be next Tuesday, let's head out towards the island, I think. And once we're over there, we can build ourselves a base over there. Because there's a lot of untapped resources over that away, which we have not tapped into whatsoever. And that would solve some of our problem of over-harvesting this area. So yeah. I know what we're going to need. I have some ideas. We're going to need to drop our acid mushroom. We're going to catch some fish and some salt and cure them so we have food for the road. We're going to get ourselves a heck of a lot of titanium. We're going to bring with us some batteries, and we're going to bring... Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna make a, for next time, I'm gonna make a list of everything we're gonna need to bring with us. And then, start of next episode, I'll go around and pick it all up and, bring it back to base. I'm sorry it was a little late on the science this time, but we did find an awful lot of cool stuff in game. So, that is always a plus. So, if you feel like coming back on Thursday, I should have, some cool science stories for you then. We're gonna be playing Depth. As usual for Thursdays. Forewarned, though, if you are tuning in on Saturday, I am not actually going to be around this Saturday. I am going out of town, and I will not have access to my beautiful gaming computer. So, thank you so much for tuning in. Let me actually get out of here so that I don't drown in between episodes, because that would be awkward. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, there's probably more on YouTube, certainly earlier Subnauticas, if you are so inclined. Thank you so much, and have a great day!